All right, we'll make this part two here on the hay. I kind of got cut short because I got visitors. So what I want to discover is you can tell the horses also have found this. And you notice the difference between these two coats here. Buddy doesn't have really long hair, but he gets kind of thick and a thick undercoat. Whereas Mr. T, he gets that long, woolly, mammoth. That's from that draft, and he was born up in the hills of Nevada as a wild Mustang. So I mean, he got all those genes for surviving these cold temps. The pros and cons between these two is Buddy, when he's dry, he feels warmer. Mr. T's hair is so long it kind of blows through. I mean, he doesn't get cold, but he just has a lot because his hair's so long. It's a different kind of warmth. When I feel him sometime in the different cold temps, Buddy will feel cooler sometimes than Mr. T. Mr. T will feel cooler sometime than Buddy. So they just take care of their own. But you see them eating this hay, and the reason behind this hay is you notice they're nibbling, they're picking through. Mr. T found a big hunk of oats right there that I didn't break up real well, so he's kind of chomping on that a little bit. your cinnamon barking. But right there where he's eating, there's a lot of oats, and he's digging through that and kind of nibbling. But if that was in a solid pack like most people feed, where they just throw a damn flank on the ground, they can't nibble. See how Buddy's kind of kicking hay around? He's kind of nibbling, he's moving, he's not taking chunks of hay like I see alfalfa, where you get this big knot of hay and they end up chewing it, and they don't work it in slowly. They don't use, you know, their saliva. I forgot the stats. I've got it listed on my site somewhere on how much saliva a horse, I want to say it's something like 7 or 8 gallons a day of saliva. I don't know. It's a lot. And every time they chew, they produce a lot, because that's where their digestive process is. That's why they don't colic. When they eat a little bit of hay, they're creating saliva, they're chewing it, the digestive process happens before it gets in the belly. When you feed a flake of hay and it's solid, and they're hungry, and they're cold, and you only feed them twice a day, see, these horses are grazing all day, so it's not like they're starving. So when I throw out food, they come and pick through it, and they're nibbling, but they're not gorging themselves. As I said before, always give grain after hay, hay first. Another thing that most people don't understand horses do. They come out, they see their horse, they give them grain. They let them eat the grain, then they throw the hay. Well, if you throw hay and grain out, a horse is going to eat the grain first every time. And then when his belly gets full and he starts filling up with hay, it pushes the grain through the system before the body has a chance to use all the grain, metabolize it, turn it into energy, and they get all the benefits from it. It stays in their belly if you feed them grain after hay. Because then they're full, they stop eating, and they have that grain sitting in their belly. The digestive process has a chance to break it down and use all the nutrients. When you feed them grain first and then hay, it gets pushed through because they're eating a bunch of hay. The hay follows through and pushes the grain out before all the nutrients are done. And that's when you get a lot of grain that's not dissolved or it's not processed. You'll find it in the poop, etc. So grain always comes after hay. Another way to realize that is feed your horse grain when they're not hungry or after they're finished eating, you know. And again, if your horse is on there and you're at a barn, you have to depend on other people to do it, or you have to drive out there 2 or 3 times. It becomes a lot of work, so therefore it's easier just to give them grain and hay. So the horses eat the grain, then they eat the hay, and they poop out the grain. But that, again, my philosophy, people, never claim to be the almighty horse, all-knowing knowledge. Other people like to say that about me, and other people like to say I don't know nothing. So I'm just passing on what my understanding is on how to keep your horse healthy. Choices, they've got choice of this hay, they've got a big round bale on the other side that they nibble on, they've got all this pasture out here that they can nibble on, there's green grass over here. If they want to eat the green grass, they can go get a little rich green grass. There's dry grass everywhere else. There's this over here. I'll throw them a few carrots. I'll throw them a few apples. Usually in the morning when I come out, I have an apple for them. And they're pretty healthy, and they seem to be doing okay. I just uploaded a nice picture. They were both laying down sleeping this morning. I don't see them both laying down too often. But the temperature out here, and another issue I have is these freaking blankets. you're in Texas, and the weather here, I mean, it gets down to 20 last night. It was 20, 19 degrees here. And today it's like 45 right now, maybe even 50. It feels pretty damn warm. And these people will put a blanket on for the night and then make the horse wear it all day today to where they sweat and it packs down. It totally defeats the purpose. And everybody's like, well, I don't know why you hate blankets. They're needed. They are needed at certain times, but they're also needed to be put on and taken off and monitored by responsible horse owners. They don't need to be put on because it's easy and then left on for three freaking days when it gets hot during the day. I mean, that's just crazy. And I'm driving around seeing these poor horses standing, trying to find shade. The sun's beating down on them. They're sweating. And their hair's getting packed down. They're sweating on their hair, so the sweat's going to dry and make it hot. So when it gets cold tonight, the blanket's going to be wet with sweat. It's going to have packed down hair, and it's going to be less than if they had just left the damn blanket off. And that's my problem with blankets. But everybody wants to make it into I hate blankets, and I hate pink, and I hate women, and I hate everything. Look, I'm just telling you, it's not good for the horse. Most things I talk about is about behavior that hurts horses. And just like feeding, people are going to go, well, I can't, Rick, it's easy for you to say to go out there and take this hay, but I don't have time. I'm busy, and I'm this, and I have to have someone else feed. And I can only say, well, I don't want to hear all the excuses, neither does your horse. If you're going to be a responsible horse owner, you're coming here watching these videos, I'm telling you what's best for the horse. I don't care if you go out there and tie the horse feet up and drag it around a pasture. I can't prevent that. I can only put out information that I think is good for the horse, and then you have the choice to either listen and use it or not listen and leave. I don't care. But you know, it's just so damn difficult for people to try to pass on knowledge to people when all they want to do is criticize, complain, make it in a negative, be PC correct, crack on what I wear, how big I am, what shoes I wear, how I don't look like a cowboy, I don't shave, my hair's too short, my hair's too long, I shouldn't wear sunglasses, I'm not professional. That knucklehead on the rope halter on Diamond, the president of Diamond, Double Diamond Rope Halters, is pain in the ass, going to write me an email about my video's unprofessional and blah, blah, blah. And look, dude, our congressmen wear suits and ties, and they're supposed to be professional, and they're ripping off and destroying the country. Okay, just because somebody calls himself a professional trainer, a professional businessman, a professional, by definition, is just somebody that gets paid for something. So, I mean, any idiot can go out there and get paid for doing something that makes them a professional. So throwing around that term professional to me, or calling me a trainer or an expert or whatever else people want to call me, I am a horseman. I understand horses. I do things for the benefit and welfare of horses. I try to pass on things that I think are good for horses. The rest of the labeling and knowledge, whatever you people want to do, it doesn't really matter to me, and I don't really care. That's why I don't take sponsors. That's why I don't take money from, you know, people wanting to put things on my website, or will you do this, will you promote? I don't want to get into that. You don't own me. I don't change my opinion. I had some guy from New York call me about 6 months ago wanting to do a video or TVs. He's with some movie studio, and he's like, yeah, you know, watch your videos, blah, blah. You know, we talk. And I could tell where he was going. He kind of wanted the drama of all the women because of all my hate mail and all this drama. And that's what I was like, look, guy, I said, I'll be honest with you. I don't mind doing a show, and I don't mind participating in a show if it's for the benefit and welfare of horses. But I'm not going to get out there and do something for sponsors or for advertisers. He goes, oh, no, I totally understand. You know what? I got another call. Let me call you back. I'll get back to you. I never heard from him again. Go figure. I don't care. Look, I don't give a shit. You want to do a video? You want me to do some TV show and come out there and try to make profit for you on the backs of horses? I'm tired of that. I'm tired of people using horses to make money. I, these horses have given enough to the country and have carried man enough and progressed and helped us grow and built our homes and our railroads and everything else, fought in our wars. They still service in police and military. I mean, horses are a part of America, and they're just part of the human culture. And if you can't get that, and you want to use them and just take from them, well, you know what? Then me and you probably ain't gonna get along. You're not gonna like what I say, and frankly, I don't give a shit.
Rick, that's not professional. You shouldn't say shit.
Shut up, buddy. Do you care how I'm talking? Hell no. A horse don't care if you're professional or not. He only cares if you're a dummy or not. Okay, so every dummy out there can call themselves a professional, and a horse don't care, and neither do I. All right, we'll end that there on hay. understanding hay, digestive system, feeding more, giving to horses free choices, allowing them to make decisions. If they eat this, great. If they don't, great. They have it. It's available. They have choices. That's what I want for horses. That's what horses want. That's how horses tend to do better. That's why they don't gorge. That's why they don't are that hungry. They're not starved. They're not fed twice a day. These horses are grazing animals and they graze. So when I throw food out, they come over, pick the good stuff out, and then they're going to leave. And then later on the night when it gets cold, if they want to come back and eat the not so good stuff, if they really need it or want it, then they have that choice too. All right? So giving horses choices is the best option and thing you can do out there for horses. Well, isn't that there, buddy Major Day, you're good boys. Like, dude, we're eating the good stuff. Shut up. You're not being professional letting us eat.